Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is your narrator Ravi Gupta. Today I'm going to talk about the Cochrane boiler. In today's topic, I will speak about how a Cochrane boiler is constructed and how it is made and why it is made like this. So, and after that we'll see a different component and why it is like that. So this is a part 2 of the smoke tube boiler. In part 1, I have spoken about the Scotch type smoke tube boiler. If you want to know about the Scotch tube smoke tube boiler, please click on the I button right above. You can watch that. So let's begin the video of the Cochrane boiler. So as you can see, first let me tell you how a basic this Cochrane boiler works. So this is a furnace area where the oil or fuel is burned, and the flue gas which is produced will go through this to its combustion chamber. In this combustion chamber, the flue gas which is collected will pass inside the tube. As the flue gas is passing inside the tube, therefore it is called a smoke tube boiler or also fire tube boiler. Okay, and as the smoke is passing inside the tube, the water is surrounded all around the tube. There will be a heat exchange with the tube, and the heat will be utilized for heating up the water, which will ultimately convert it into the steam and will collect it in this dome surface area. Now, as the smoke is losing heat, it will ultimately exchange the heat and will come out, and through the smoke box, it will go up as an exhaust to chimney. Okay. Now, the hemispherical dome mainly consists of several mounting such as steam stop valve, which will provide the steam for auxiliary purpose use through this. Okay, these are the safety valve which will be lifted if the pressure inside the boiler is raised beyond the certain design pressure limit. This is a pressure gauge indicating what are the pressure inside the boiler. Gauge glass indicating the water level indication. So these are the mounting which are provided in the boiler cell. Now let's come to the construction part. Cochrane boiler is a vertical tube boiler used for supplying low pressure auxiliary steam. So where the Cochrane boiler is used is clear. It is used for the low pressure auxiliary steam purposes. Okay, now hemispherical seamless furnace. Okay, so this is the type of furnace which is used in a Cochrane boiler. As you can see, the furnace is hemispherical in nature. Okay, hemispherical in nature. Why hemispherical in nature? The furnace is hemispherical in nature because hemispherical body have a special property. Hemispherical body can withstand the stress without the requirement of additional stiffening member. Means the hemispherical body can withstand the bending stress, can withstand the internal stress without the requirement of stay tube, without the requirement of stiffening member. And for that reason, it is not only cost effective, it also reduces the overall cost. For that reason, hemispherical surfaces are used in the stress region area, and hence the furnace is hemispherical in nature, and hence the dome of the steam tube is also hemispherical in nature. Now, the fuel is burned in this furnace and the flue gas passes through the combustion chamber to smoke tube. So as I have told you, the flue gas is produced in this furnace, hemispherical furnace, and will go to the combustion chamber, which ultimately go to the smoke tube. Now, O-gearing, very important thing. Hemispherical furnace is attached to the boiler cell by the means of the O-gearing. So what is O-gearing? This is O-gearing. Okay, the O-gearing is provided so that the hemispherical furnace can be attached to the boiler cell plating. For that attachment, a O-gearing is provided. This O-gearing is subjected to deformation. For that reason, a refractory material is provided around the O-gearing to prevent the direct heat coming to the O-gearing and to the boiler cell plate. Now, to prevent deformation from heating, the refractory is provided. But the water which is used in the Cochrane boiler is of poor quality feed water, which may contain impurities that may get collected here, which will increase the heat gain and will ultimately also lead to the heat deformation. So for that reason, a handle door is provided in front of the O-ring, so that by inserting a hand and we can remove the dirt and dust impurities time to time to prevent the undue deformation of this O-ring. So for that reason, it means what? The O-ring is very sensitive thing which is attaching the boiler furnace to the boiler cell plating. But to take care of that, we are providing refractory as well as handle door, so that to prevent deformation. Handle door is removing the impurities which is collected from the water, and refractory is preventing direct heat to the O-ring. So same thing I have written here. Hemispherical furnace is attached to the boiler cell by the means of O-ring. To prevent undue deformation, it is protected by refractory material. And to prevent undue accumulation such as mud, salt, etc., handle door is provided for timely removal. Now, third thing is a hemispherical boiler cell together with the hemispherical furnace eliminate the requirement of stay tube or the other external support, as hemispherical crown is self-sufficient to accommodate the stress. As I have told you earlier, why we are using hemispherical crown or hemispherical furnace? We are using it so that it can accommodate the stress within itself without any requirement of external member. Now, refractory material. It is provided in the combustion chamber and around the furnace. The main aim is to conserve the heat within the boiler. So, as you can see, the refractory material is surrounding the furnace area and the combustion chamber area. So main purpose of the refractory material is to conserve the radiant heat which is produced in the boiler. This radiant heat, if the refractory material is not there, in that case the boiler cell plating will be reflected direct to the radiant heat, and hence to prevent the overheating of the boiler cell plating, we need to provide thick boiler cell plating, which will ultimately increase the cost. To prevent the increase the cost, we are using refractory material. But now, the refractory material should be such that it not only prevent the heat, but also help to increase the efficiency of the boiler. Means refractory material help to increase the efficiency by conserving the heat. And for that reason, it is provided. Access to the boiler internal part is provided through manhole door at the top of the spherical cell for internal inspection. So as you can see here, that manhole door is provided, which is provided so that we can inspect the steam drum area and steam space, whether it is okay or not, whether everything is fine or not, the tubes are in condition, perfect condition or not, and the cell plating, hemispherical crown, is any accumulation or corrosion. Therefore, that the manhole door is provided. Here, a handle door is provided for inspection of the O-ring. And here, a smoke hinge door is provided to see the combustion chamber area and to see the condition of the tube. And for also cleaning of the tube, this hinge smoke door is provided in the combustion chamber area, which will be timely removed, and we will inspect the smoke tube and the combustion chamber area. So hinge smoke door is provided to give access to the combustion chamber. Handle is provided to the bottom to remove muds. So as you can see that now, a manhole provided for the inspection of top part, a hinge door is provided for inspection of the combustion chamber and the smoke tube part, and a handle is provided for inspection of the O-ring. So by this, we are inspecting the Cochrane boiler from in time to time. And why it is hemispherical, now you know that. And why it is designed in such a way, now you know that. One more thing I want to tell you, that in the earlier model, when the coal was used as a primary fuel, The ash pit was provided in the bottom of the Cochrane boiler, which where the ash of the coal was collected and it is timely removed. It was removed by the oil burn furnace in the newer model. So, my friend, in this video you have learned how a Cochrane boiler works. If you want to know the same thing about the smoke tube boiler of the Scotch type, you can watch my video, which will be appear in the end screen. I hope you like the video. Please do comment below if you have any doubt, and please do subscribe and share. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.